let's see one more question based on roots of complex number. Now the question is, prove that nth roots of unity are in GP. And we know that unity is nothing but one. So nth roots of unity, that is nth root of one. So to find it, we will consider x raised to n as 1. Now we want nth root. So that is why we will take nth root on both sides. So we will get x equal to 1 raised to 1 upon n. Now the question is, we have to prove that these roots are in GP. GP is geometric progression. So to prove this, we have to find out all the roots of this unity, and then we'll see whether they are in GP or not. So what I'll do is, now I'll convert this number in polar form, because we want to find nth root of this number, and the number is in Cartesian form, so it's not possible to apply de Moivre's theorem. So I'm converting this in polar form. So in polar form, this one will become cos of 0 plus I sine 0 raised to 1 by n. Now I've already told you that in this type of problems we have to consider general polar form of complex number. So here I will consider this as cos of 2k pi plus I sine 2k pi. So I'm adding 2k pi in amplitude so that it will become general polar form. Now next, I will apply de Moivre's theorem. So by de Moivre's theorem, we will get cos of 2k pi upon n plus I sine 2k pi upon n. Now we have to find n roots. So we will take n values of k. So we always start value of k with 0. So we'll take values of 0, 1, 2. Now we have to consider n value. So last value will be n minus 1. So we will substitute each value. Then we will find out roots. And let's see whether they are in GP or not. So I'm starting with 0. So when k is equal to 0, that time we will get x0 as k is 0, so this term will become 0. So cos of 0 plus I sine 0, this will give me 1. So x0 is 1. Next, when k is equal to 1, so you all know that when k is 1, this will become 2 pi upon n. So x1 will be cos of 2 pi upon n plus I sine 2 pi upon n. Now to prove that all these roots are in GP, I am considering the given root. Now to prove that all the roots are in GP, what I'll do is, I will consider the roots in the polar form as omega, and I will find the further roots in terms of omega. So I'm considering this cos 2 pi by n plus I sine 2 pi by n as omega. Let's see what is the next root. So to find next root, I will substitute k as 2. So when I will substitute k as 2, I will get here 2 into 2, that is 4 pi upon n. So therefore, when k is equal to 2, we will get x2 as cos of 4 pi upon n plus I sine 4 pi upon n. Now I can represent this in terms of omega. So this will become cos of 2 pi upon n plus I sine 2 pi upon n, the whole square. So here I am applying de Moivre's theorem, and I have taken out 2 outside. Now we have considered cos of 2 pi upon n plus I sin 2 pi upon n as omega. So here it will become omega square, because the value of this bracket is omega. Similarly, we'll find next roots. So when k is equal to 3, so when k is 3, we will get x3, which is nothing but cos of 6 pi upon n plus I sine 6 pi upon n. This will give me cos of 2 pi upon n plus I sine 2 pi upon n whole raised to 3, that is omega cube. And so on, we will find all the roots. So when k is equal to n minus 1, that time we will get x of n minus 1, that is nth root, as cos of 2 times n minus 1 into pi upon n plus I sine 2 into n minus 1 into pi upon n. So using de Moivre's theorem, it will give me cos of 2 pi upon n plus I sine 2 pi upon n whole raised to n minus 1, that is omega raised to n minus 1. So you can observe here that when k was 2, we are getting omega square, k is 3, we are getting omega cube, and when k is n minus 1, we are getting omega raised to n minus 1. So we got values as 1 as the first root, omega as the second root, omega square as the third root, omega cube as the fourth root, and so on. The last root was, and so on, and the last root was omega raised to n minus 1. And these all roots are in GP, that is geometric progression, because the ratio between any two terms is constant and is equal to omega. So we have proved that these terms are in GP.